guided violin practice. I'm very happy to be part of this wonderful project organized by the Michael Hill International Violin Competition in New Zealand and share with you some ideas and tips on practicing violin. My name is Ioana Cristina Goicea, I'm a violinist and I'm the winner of the Michael Hill International Violin Competition in New Zealand in 2017. For today's video, I chose an excerpt, the beginning, the first page of the Bruch Violin Concerto No. 1 in G minor. Now I'd like to share a few general comments on practicing, which is the key of successful performances. You've probably heard many times how important is the quality in the practicing and not the quantity, because nobody will ask you how many hours you spend with the violin. So very shorter but concentrated and very intelligent practice will bring you much more than the whole day staying with the instrument and with your mind flying somewhere else. Also, another aspect, a very important one, is to listen to yourself with critical ear when you practice at home, which means for me to record myself, to record like excerpts and listen immediately. I know this method can be very, very frustrating, but it really helps so much to improve. And also to be very structured in the repertoire. When you, for example, have a very big repertoire for competitions, and I was personally never practicing every day everything. So I always try to structure and to think about which movements I want to do today and concentrate on this. So in this way I had much more variety and every day I could improve something more. So now the opening of Bruch Concerto, the first phrase. So the first thing what I'm thinking about is the character and the phrasing. How I shape this beautiful phrase. So how I distribute my bow, how much bow I use. Not too much in the beginning, and also what is the speed of the bow that I need. And slow. And also another very important aspect is that the wrist is very flexible so that you can connect very beautifully between strings. Yeah. For the second part of the opening, I want to create a more intense and deep sound. So it's very important that you find the right position, which is not too near to sul tasto and also not too near to the bridge, so that you can create a deep, intense sound without needing to press. Also very important is the vibrato. The vibrato must be faster and more intense. For the marcato section, it needs to be very precise rhythmically and very articulated. So when I practice, I think about where I place my bow in order to catch the double stops precisely in the same time without needing to press. So the energy comes also from the right arm. The energy on the chords and on the double stops. For the arpeggios, I practice them firstly slowly. To hear each note, then I practice them a bit faster and then faster. And also I do practice generally when there is legato, I practice in detaché, and when it's detaché, I practice in legato. So that every note is clear. double stops. I don't practice them in forte. I don't play too loud when I practice double stops, and I do play them legato first so that I can hear the connection between the double stops. Practice the octaves and then it's also possible to practice it rhythmical. But the most important is not to press on them, because in the moment when you press, the intonation will not be good anymore. So one last subject that I would like to talk to you briefly about are the chords. How to achieve a beautiful round sound on chords without pressing. So for me, the best way to practice the chords at first is in piano and legato. And slowly, of course. Then very important, not only in the chords generally, but especially in the chords, is that the right hand is anticipating. And the right hand is more active and it's before the right hand. In this way you will have better coordination and also better intonation. And another thing about chords is to be aware of the place where you place your bow and not to land on the fingerboard. You lose from the intensity of the sound. And also do try using a bit more bow on the chord, so they sound very open and not tight. I hope this was helpful for you, and hope to see you soon.